Well, I'm thrilled to be here today with all of you, and I'm going to share some thoughts about the Cox Automotive journey in just a few minutes. And it is about our cloud journey and our data-first journey. And I'm going to share a few things really about the journey and the steps that we took. A lot of things that we did that we find that were successful. I also want to tell you some of the tried and true measures that we've been able to use to get to where we are today. But first, let me tell you a little bit about Cox Automotive. We are roughly about a $9 billion company, part of Cox Enterprises, and we serve the entire automotive ecosystem through software, through services, and many different types of capabilities. But we've grown through acquisition. We are over 70 different acquisitions. And in those acquisitions, you can only imagine what came with that. We had different skills, we had different levels of maturity, we had different levels of types of tech stacks, and it was quite an interesting ecosystem. And in that, we were able to start a transformation journey. And we made a decision in 2018 to run like one Cox Automotive. And you say, what does that mean? Well, that really means that we went from a product-centric organization to an enterprise-type organization, meaning that we wanted to be solution-focused. And the journey that we've been on has enabled us to do that, to actually help our customers thrive in a marketplace that is really changing very rapidly. And today, we have, across all of our brands, solutions that are helping us do just that. Now, our journey started before I actually even started with Cox. I started in 2018. And my very first day on the job, I found myself in Seattle at the AWS offices. Because just before starting, the company made three key decisions. One was that we needed to get out of the 53 different data centers that we had, and we needed to go to the cloud. So there was a decision there. The second decision is that we needed to implement Agile as a business methodology. And the third was that we needed to be way more intentional about our data. So when I came back from being in Seattle, it became very clear to me that I had to resell the leadership team on why we needed to go to the cloud. It wasn't just about taking expense out. It really had to be about having a nimbleness, having an agility to grow. So that was a big deal. So we started on our journey. We talk about our data back in 17 and 16 being swampy, and we really kind of had to get out of that. So be super intentional about that. The levers that we used have really been able to get us to where we are today. And I will tell you what's been interesting about that is today, so 4 years later, we are all in on AWS. We have over 500 workloads in the cloud. We have our data in a marketplace in one component that we call DriveQ, and it has ubiquitous access across our entire ecosystem. And those have been keys to unlocking value. Just to give you a feel for the kind of productivity that's come out of these moves, on average in our ecosystem, we launch anywhere from 20 to 30 new products a year. We do over 10,000 feature enhancements to our ecosystem and over 80 new integrations every year. And we wouldn't be able to do that if we had not made this journey. And going all in on our cloud and our data journey was key to that success. We had to do that not only with AWS, but with the partners that were part of the ecosystem there. That was key. And you know, if we think about the data, you heard a lot this morning about how important it is. To be able to go fast and create differentiation, you've got to be super intentional about your data. We did all the things you have to do. How you ingest, how you acquire, how you make sure you take care of data exhaust, how you catalog it, index it, and make it available. So that changed even our model delivery. We do a lot of model delivery. We went from quarters, we went to months, we went to days, and now we're deploying new models in hours. So significant change. And one of the keys to our success was being nimble in how we did it, asking ourselves where we were getting in our own way, and be willing to change those things and be able to level up. I heard the phrase this morning, race to the top. I wrote that down, that's sticking. It's how do we level up? And that's been key to our journey. Now, I want to bring it to life for you a little bit more. It isn't about those data centers. Remember I said 53? We retired 50 of those data centers. We only have three now. And that is for the environments that are not fit for purpose for the cloud. We are all operating in the cloud. But we had to think about how do we maintain the right amount of cost, elasticity, but turn on speed and innovation. And that's been a big part of what you see here. It's personalization now that is available through our data. It's also advanced imaging that plays a part in our ecosystem. And it's also about conversational AI. How do we engage with our consumers? How do we engage with our customers? All those things are happening now through recommendations. If you've ever been on Kelly Blue Book, if you're on Auto Trader, and then how we help our retailers connect with their consumers. It's all now happening and it's been made real. And so those things are just to name a few, but at the end of the day, we couldn't do any of those if we weren't that intentional about our data. It all starts with the data. Now, once you have the data, then you can apply your advanced techniques, whether it's machine learning, natural language processing, or computer vision. And those are all things that are artificial intelligence and give you the right jump-off point to be able to go after Gen AI. Now, I want to give you a couple examples. We talked about personalization a second ago. I don't care what business you're in, whether it's a B2C, B2B, B2B2C, personalization is a big deal. We created a product embedded in our e-commerce solutions called Magic Qual. Magic Qual, through our AI technology and our data, is a feature that's embedded in those e-commerce platforms that actually will enable a consumer, if you were buying a vehicle, would only get 5 pieces of information from you, do a soft credit pull, and we could tell you exactly what your monthly payment would be, and knowing that you could get financed and a loan for that for sure, so you would have confidence in that. Then it becomes all about making it personalized to you. What vehicles are you interested in? That's all data driven. And now we know what you can afford. And so the ability for us to actually get a consumer to buy a vehicle, their affordability and their interest, those that engage with the Magic Qual, 10 times are more likely to put that vehicle in their shopping cart. And for those that do that, are 2 times more likely to actually purchase the vehicle. So it's a big deal when you're leveraging your data. Now, what do you do when you have access to millions and millions of vehicles? You image them, and then you use our patented technology to turn that into a digital twin. And that is what we've done. Our fixed imaging tunnels and our mobile capture, it's our patented fusion technology, that is set a new standard in the industry for vehicle imaging. And it's an industry first. Our FITs, as we call them, the tunnels, actually produce through 50 different cameras, we have over 90 different light panels that produce over 2,500 images that allow us to produce 90 images that are assessed and then pick the actually best 12. And what happens from that is those images are so high res, you can see road rash on the vehicle, you can see a scratch on the tire, you can actually read the text on the side rim of a wheel. So it gives so much confidence. If you're the seller of the vehicle, you know what you need to do to recondition and what your return on investment should be for that vehicle. If you're a buyer, it gives you the confidence of what's the actual condition of the vehicle and gives you comfort in the purchase that you're making. And just one more example to bring it to life. Because we've done so much with AI, AI is not new to us, and what we've done with our data, we've been able to step into what I call pragmatically aggressive, and I'll say that again, pragmatically aggressive on Gen AI. And we've been able to do that, and we're already starting to see some differentiation for solutions that we can serve our market better. And I will tell you that because we've done what we just talked about, the experimentation is happening rapidly. So we're really excited about the potential promise of what we're seeing there. So our AI practices are now leveled up. I have a lot of engineers, I have over 100 here at the conference today, and they're all getting access to be able to play and use and learn rapidly. So just a couple of examples. We do a lot of contact communication with our customers and with consumers, but we also believe that Gen AI is going to be able to make that communication more relevant, more timely, and more personalized. So we're pursuing that. If we think about what we do is manage search engine optimization, so SEO. We believe that we can do that with higher quality, we can do it more efficiently, and we can generate revenue for that. So those are just 2 examples of many examples that we have in flight right now. So my advice to all of you is just to get started. And what I have shown up here, I am not going to unpack this, but if you want to take a picture, I would suggest that you do. These principles that we share up here are our key success factors in how we went to the cloud, the buy-in from our business leaders, as well as our data journey. We all know that the data space and the AI space is moving rapidly, and you cannot sit on the sideline. You need to make decisions. So I would encourage you to lean in, be in it, be in motion. As I'm not unpacking this, I also want to tell you that these actions up here are very actionable. They're great tips for how you want to move forward in your organization. To leverage your data, leverage your position, so that you can take advantage of these advanced techniques. And I talked about being all in with AWS and their partners, and I'll give a shout out to RapidScale, which is a Cox company, which is in that partner ecosystem, who can help you. But that is how we have leaned in. We've taken advantage of everything. And what I heard this morning excites me. So we are going to race to the top with what's next. I would leave you with radical transparency, manage your expense along the way, show value as you go, let that build momentum, but focus on outcomes. If you haven't started, start. If you're early in, lean in and accelerate. And if you're all in like we have been, I want to talk to you because I'm pretty sure we can learn something from each other. So thank you very much, and I'm going to turn it back over to Andy.